parabéns, aguardado do que nunca, um especial Stroke, sim, essa banda nova-iorquina que está dando o que falar, né? Edição do disco americano, uma faixa diferente, tiraram o New York City Cops, que fala da polícia de Nova York, é claro, hoje eles são heróis e não dá pra falar nada da polícia, então eles acharam melhor tirar a música e lá atrasou o lançamento. Saiu primeiro até aqui no Brasil, já saiu o disco do Strokes no Brasil, pode procurar, eu tô falando a verdade. E a gente tem uma entrevista com o baterista, o brasileiro Fabrício Moretti, fizemos lá em Reading, enquanto estivemos em Reading, e temos também um registro maravilhoso do Strokes, vamos lá.
I started playing the drums when I was about 12, and my friends in school, Nick and Julian, we went to school together, and we were all starting to get interested in music, so and we figured, oh, we're friends, let's play some music together, you know? So we did, and that's how we started out. It's about 2 years old, but I don't know, we've been playing music, like I said, since we were like 13 or 14 years old. So it's been a very long time.
What do you, have you had any other band before the Strokes? The Strokes were the first band.
Yeah, that was what's so cool about the Strokes, you know? Because we're friends before we're musicians. So there's no egos, there's no problems, you know, we're all very close.
I think the first release from the Strokes was Modern Age, the single. And Rough Trade in London released it, the single, I think they first released it, the single. How did you meet the people of Rough Trade? Did you send a demo tape to Dan? How did it happen?
Well, it's the story begins in New York, really, because there was this one place called the Mercury Lounge, which is like the contemporary CBGBs, and we wanted to play that place very much. And the booking agent there, his name is Ryan. He's now our manager. Like he booked us there, and like we played our show, and he came up to us and he said, you know, I'd like to sort of manage you guys, you know? And we were like, shit, wow, that's crazy, that's really cool. And he's the one who took our demo tape. Our demo tape, which we really like wanted to use just to give to venues so that we could play there, you know? He took it and sent it to Jeff Travis at Rough Trade. And Jeff just called him up during the Modern Age, the first song, and he was like, I want to bring these guys over, I want to record with these guys. And so thank God, man. Thank you, Jeff Travis.
How it was for you, because when the single was released by Rough Trade, it was single of the week for the New Musical Express. It was a surprise for you, I think.
That was crazy. That was insane. In fact, when I saw the enemy, I was like, I think it was more like this. It was like, I was sitting back and just like, oh, shit. After the Modern Age EP came out here in England, Jeff Travis and Rough Trade like wanted to test us with other recorders and other producers and stuff. Sorry. And it was cool because we got to learn so much about the recording process, but it never sounded like us. You know what I mean? So we decided to go back to the guy, to our producer, Gordon Raphael, who recorded the first EP, The Modern Age, because our songs are built a certain way, they're created a certain way, that if they are not recorded in a light, in like sort of a rough type, underground type sensation, it doesn't feel right, you know what I mean? And so we went back to Gordon and we recorded the whole album with him in a small little stupid studio under Avenue A in New York City, and it was the best time ever. And I'm really proud of the album because it's like just five guys and this producer who really, really just wanted to make good music, you know.
The album is dedicated to a guru, J.B.
Bowersock, yeah.
Who's this guy?
Who's this man? Who's this guru?
he was a guitar teacher for Albert's guitar teacher. And then he became Julian's guitar teacher. And then he became all of our teachers, really. He helped me, like, learn. So he taught me so much about just playing the drums to fit the music, you know what I mean? I used to play very, like, conservatively. And he's like, well, just listen to the music, listen to the energy. Explode, you know, explode on stage. And so he's a guru, that's what he is. He's a teacher, you know. And he knows music so well, and he was there during the recording, and he helped us. He was an interpreter for us. Like, we said what we wanted to do, and he turned it into technical language, you know what I mean?
His name is the stage, because we were going to play in a tent, but it's too small, the tent, for so many people who wants to see the band. And then the people change it for the main stage.
Yeah, that was very cool. I mean, honestly, I wish we were playing the smaller stage because it's more intimate, you know what I mean? But for safety reasons, they said you gotta play here. And when they said that, I was like, okay.
And you're gonna play before Iggy Pop. I think Iggy Pop and the Stooges are a big reference for your work.
Yes, very much. Lust for Life, the album, is one of my favorite albums of all time. I don't know, the David Bowie and Iggy Pop, they're just amazing back then, you know.
Have you met Iggy Pop before?
No. This is going to be the first time.
Oh, great.
This is intense.
Oh, great.
For all you Brazilians out there. About the future. Wow, that's a good one. I don't know, they expect a lot of about us, you know, they want us to be a certain type of band, and if we listen to them, if we listen to the press, we become big-headed and we lose sight of what we wanted to do. What we want to do in the future is make good music, and that's it. It doesn't matter if we make money, it doesn't matter if we make fans. What matters is that we try our hardest to project our music out to as many people as we possibly can. So. Espera por mim que eu venho em breve. I'll be there really, really soon, and we'll rock your world.
Okay.
Espero que eles entendem isso.
E ficamos por aqui com o Lado B. Semana que vem tem mais. Lembrando, o nosso e-mail, ladob@mtv.com.br. Reprises, domingo, 7:30 de la matina. Segunda, 1 da tarde. Sexta, 11:30 da noite. Sábado, aqui, às 6 da tarde. Tchau, tchau.